We are required to report to global figures every day the healthcare workers that are ill, that are having COVID-19 symptoms, and that's for a variety of reasons. The total figure you have now of healthcare workers is 10. We have 10 healthcare workers that have turned out to be positive, and one person who works in administration in a health facility. Out of the 10 healthcare workers, you now know that one person is an employee of Karl Huchner. Six persons are in the private sector, and three persons are in the public sector. Out of this, in the public sector, we have one pharmacist, one doctor, and one nurse. As I had stipulated before, in our contact tracing, we have not been able to identify that any of these three officers would have gotten infected in the actual line of duty at work. And it's important that we stress that, and I'll see why that has implications as we move along. And I think it has implications for obvious reasons that we would all be aware of. One doctor at Karl Huchner, it would not seem from the initial contact tracing that has been done that he would have been infected in the line of duty. And as a matter of fact, the reason why he was swabbed is because he was linked to a previously identified case. So I think we need to stress that. And in terms of the six health staff outside of the healthcare, the public sector, then it's in private sector. We have one lab technician, one pharmacist, two nurses, and two doctors. Of course, the contact tracing in those elements continue, but it doesn't seem that people from the health sector would all necessarily be infected at work or in the line of duty.